insert the pads and put the caliper on. Let's see here. I gotta remember which ones are which. This one. Face there. And this one. We'll say that. Now, when you're assembling this, it's going to be a bit of a pain because you got these. So, you got to make sure you don't lose your shim. Is that in the camera? I think I showed you the shim. Hold on, let me lower this caliper down. Okay. Don't lose your shim. And make sure that these little clips stay inside here.
See where my finger is?
Now, an easy way to do this is to insert the first bolt up, but I had forgotten to wire brush these, so I'm going to wire brush these and get right back to you. Let's free our caliper.
Come on, get out of there, you bastard.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this bolt in first, just finger tight. Where's my extra hand? And that will act as a pivot. Now I gotta get a different angle here so I can make sure those clips stay put. See, I've already got one that's wanting to push out. So just take your time with it. Make sure those clips stay put. Beauty. So now, I've got my Loctite on there. You push that in. Where are we? Enough pressure to get that started. Now you're going to have to mess around with this a bit because you definitely don't want to cross thread these either. So, let me get these finger tight, or at least surface tight anyway. I'm double checking, all that's on, everything's good. And if I had my screw for my rotor, that would be not moving around like that. Okay, what did I need? I needed a 15 and a 13. There we go. Hey, have you heard the word? Bird, the bird, the bird, bird, bird. Okay, so these ones, oops, where's my 15 here? Hold the slider with your 15. 25 pounds. Click. Now yours might be different. So check out and see. Oops, how am I going to do this here? Okay. One click. Oh, man. I'm going to have a smaller one too. One click. There you go. Brake job. 98 Jetta GLS with a 2.0. My clips are in. We're good to go. Now I didn't have to bleed anything because I didn't disconnect anything. Don't forget to take your wire away. You don't want that dangling around. So all I gotta do now is put the tire back on, well, do the other side, Put the tires back on, we're good to go. Hope you learned something. I'm still not very good at teaching, but I figure my mixed up words and watching between the two of them, you should learn something. One thing, I had an issue with my wrench. Where are we? Here we are. It was a little bit too thick to fit on the 15 here between the metal shim where the booty goes on. So what I did is I took to the grinder, and you probably can't tell, too shiny. But basically I grinded the sides off here, grinded the side down here, and narrowed the profile. Now it fits in there beautifully. Much thanks to a Craigslist deal. Picked this up. He had the sales receipts and everything. From 1982 he bought this. It's in brand new condition. I got it for $40 with all the original manuals and a thing of kerosene and a pump. These still go for $270, I believe. But this thing is like, the receipt was 1982. And even though it doesn't heat the shop, it heats the work area pretty damn good. I've got another one that I actually found in the garbage. Where is it? Right there. I bought the wick for it. It's all in pieces, but all the pieces are there. I'm actually going to be putting the wick and everything back in it and make a video of it. And then I'll have two of these. I can have one on either side. I'll be sandwiched. This one's like 9,000 BTU and the other one's 8,000 BTU. So until I can afford to buy the chimney pieces I need for my wood stove, that's about the best I'm going to do for in here. But I don't mind the cold. It's the elements I hate. So I'll take cold with a bit of heat relief for my thingies and having a roof over my head.